حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه كما يحب ربنا ويرضى. وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وبعد. إن شاء الله تعالى يا إخوان, we are thankful to our Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala for this opportunity to come before the brothers and to read from this tremendous work of Yum al-Ajurri al-Sharia with the explanation of our Sheikh Rabi' Hafidhahullah ta'ala. And we thank this masjid and these brothers for their invitation and the good thought they have of their brother and the Imam Abdul Razak, Allah Yahfadhu, and all of those who participated in bringing this tremendous affair together. I wanted to start, Ya Ikhwan, La Yabarik Fikum, as it relates to the mention of the Iftiraq Al-Umam, the division and the dividing of the Umam, and those narrations, Ikhwan, that are collected or connected to that matter. The Messenger of Allah Muhammad ﷺ informed us, Ikhwan, regarding Ummah Musa, the nation of Musa, أَنَّهُمْ اِخْتَلَفُوا عَلْ إِحْدَى وَسَبْعِينَ مِلَّةِ, that they divided upon 71 different paths. كُلَّهَا فِي النَّارِ إِلَّا وَاحِدَةً, all of them in the fire except for one. And informed us, Ikhwan, regarding the Ummah of Isa, عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ, أَنُّهُمْ اِخْتَلَفُوا عَلَيْهِ عَلْ إِثْنَتَيْنِ وَسَبْعِينَ مِلَّةً إِحْدَى وَسَبْعُونَ مِنْهَا فِي النَّارِ وَوَاحِدَ فِي الْجَنَّةِ, that they divided into 72 different sects, one of them in 71 of them in the fire and one of them in the paradise. As for this ummah, as we are aware, Ikhwan, from the many narrations and the different wordings as it relates to this matter, he mentions, Ikhwan, that this ummah exceeds that by one, meaning 73. 72 in the fire and one in paradise. And as it mentions in one of the wordings, مَأَنَا عَلَيْهِ وَصْحَابِي, what I am upon and my companions. وَاحِدَ فِي الْجَنَّةِ وَهِيَ الْجَمَاعَةِ, and another wording, what I, that one in paradise, it is the jama'ah. And we have mentioned, Ikhwan, on numerous occasions, the meaning of al-jama'ah. As Ibn Mas'ud mentions, Ikhwan, مَوَافَقَ الْحَقِّ وَأَنْ كُنْتَ وَحْدَكَ, that which is in accordance with the truth, even if one be alone. So as we have said before, Ikhwan, on numerous occasions, and we repeat and reiterate, it's not a matter of numbers. It is not a matter of numbers. It is a matter of adherence to the truth. It is a matter of تَمَسُّقْ بِالسُّنَّةِ, of adherence to the sunnah and clinging firmly upon the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad alayhi salatu wassalam. We find, Ikhwan, in the tremendous narration of Yusuf ibn Asbal, he says, Usul al-Bida' Arba', he says, the foundations, Ikhwan, of innovation are four. The foundations of innovation are four. Who knows the four groups that are the foundation of bid'ah? I was looking for somebody to call on. Somebody. Hey, tafaddal. What's your name, akhi? Nasir. Where are you from? From Philadelphia. Nasir from Philadelphia. Tayyib, go ahead. You said, Rawafid. Khawarij, Qadriya, and the Murjiya. Hey, tafaddal. Give it to somebody else then. You answered the question. That's how we do it, akhi. So he mentions, Ikhwan, that those four, as our brother has mentioned, Ar-Rawafidh, Wal-Khawarij, Wal-Qadriya, Wal-Murjiya. And I will be discussing, Ikhwan, in particular in a moment, inshallah ta'ala, the Khawarij. بإذن الله تبارك وتعالى. ثم تتشاعب كل فرقة ثمانية عشر طائفة فتلك اثنتان وسبعون فرقة. So each one of those ikhwan divided into 18 different schisms. And this ikhwan is the reality of the people of division, the people of innovation. They continue to splinter. And they continue to split and divide ikhwan as we see here. And the 18 different yani sects amongst them or schisms amongst them. Until totally or equaling 72 sects. وَالثَّالِثَ وَسَبْعُونَ الْجَمَاعَةَ التي قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إنها الناجية. And he says, as for that 73rd إخوان, and then he says regarding them, then that is al-jama'ah, that is the jama'ah, of which the Messenger of Allah Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said is the saved group. And as we mentioned from the other wording, what I am upon today and my companions. And he mentions إخوان after this a number of different narrations, يعني with the same different wording with the same meaning. And we know that Shaykhuna Shaykh Muqbali mentioned ikhwan rahimahullah ta'ala that this is min dala'al an-nubuwah, that the likes of these narrations are from proofs of prophethood. And as we know, the ulama of al-Islam, ya ikhwan, have written a number of works and regarding this affair, and some of them have named them specifically dala'al an-nubuwah, the proofs of prophethood. And from them is our Shaykh, Shaykhuna Shaykh Muqbal rahimahullah ta'ala, in the modern days. And one of the more famous books, yani, or writers or authors of a work by this title, yani, the proofs of prophethood, is who? From the past. Which one of the scholars has a book, yani, regarding the proofs of prophethood? From the scholars of hadith, huh? Al-Bayhaqi. You were going to say Bayhaqi? Al-Bayhaqi. I'll give you a book. Al-Bayhaqi. Allah yabarifikum. Naam. So Shaykhuna Shaykh Rabi Ikhwani mentions after, yani, as we said in the chapter, a number of narrations in this regard. Shaykhuna Shaykh Rabi, he mentions Ikhwan, فَقَدْ ذَكَرَ الْمُؤَلِّفْ فِي الْبَابِ السَّابِقِ بَابُ وُجُوبَ الْاِعْتِصَامِ بِكِتَابِ اللَّهِ. Now, he mentions Ikhwan that the author of this work, Al-Ajurri, rahimahullah, in the previous chapter, not the chapter that we are reading now, but the previous chapter that precedes this, he brings the chapter, ikhwan, of the obligation of clinging to the book of Allah wa sunnati Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad alayhi salatu wassalam. So the book begins with what first, ikhwan? The clinging to the sunnah. And in the second chapter, deals with the separation of the division of the ummah. So he mentions this, ikhwan, to show us the ordering of this tremendous imam in this book. وعقب ذلك بهذا الباب, and then of course he follows it with this particular chapter, باب ذكر افتراق الأمم في دينهم, and the chapter regarding the division of the umm, the different nations regarding their religion. وعلى كم تفترق هذه الأمة, and it's a how many sects this ummah will divide, and it's a how many sects this ummah will divide. فالله تبارك وتعالى قال واعتصموا بحبل الله جميعا ولا تفرقوا. And then he mentions the verse from the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ikhwan, Ali Imran, ayat number 103. Ali Imran, ayat number 103. And hold on all of you together to the rope of Allah. And we are familiar, ya Ikhwan, as Sheikh Muhammad Aman al-Jami, he mentions, rahimahullah ta'ala, and others from the ulama of al-Islam, that the meaning of the rope of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, Ikhwan, is kitab Allah wa sunnah Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is the holding on or clinging to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the sunnah of his messenger alayhi salatu wassalam. This is the meaning, ikhwan, of the habl of Allah, the rope of Allah. And look in the books of tafsir, ikhwan. Look at Tabari. And look at Al-Baghawi. And look at Shawkani. Other than them, ikhwan, from the ulama who have written books of tafsir, giving commentary upon the verses in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they have mentioned, ikhwan, the statements of the Salaf al-Salih, the noble companions and the tabi'een, which about tabi'een as it relates to the affair of the meaning of the habl of Allah, and it is the book of Allah and the sunnah of his messenger alayhi salatu wassalam. And then he mentions, ikhwan, وَجَاءَ تَبْوِيب عَلَى مَضْمُون هَذِهِ الْآيَةِ, and he has brought chaptering, ikhwan, that is connected or related to this verse, yani related to this verse that we just mentioned, the command بِاعْتِصَام بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ, the command of holding fast and holding tight upon the rope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وفي هذا آيات كثيرة. And in this meaning, إخوان, in this affair, there are many verses in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And of course, many ahadith upon the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that point to this affair. وَأَوَامِرْ بِالْتِبَاعِ وَأَمَارَ تَنْهَى عَنْ مَعَسِيَةَ الرَّسُولِ وَالْإِخْتِلَافُ وَتَفَرُّقُ. And many, إخوان, that call with the command of al-itiba' of following the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the prohibition, إخوان, of disobeying the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the prohibition of dividing and separating. The prohibition of dividing and separating. Sheikh Rabi continues, إخوان, وَالْخَيْرْ كُلُّ الْخَيْرْ فِي اجْتِمَاعِ هَذِي الْأُمَّةِ عَلَى كِتَابِ رَبِّهَا وَسُنَّةِ نَبِيِّهَا. And this is a very important point, yeah, إخوان. All good, every good comes, إخوان, in coming together, uniting upon the Book of Allah and upon the Sunnah of His Messenger, His Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It did not stop by saying all good comes in uniting or unity and left generally. For far too many people, إخوان, misunderstand this matter of unity. You hear them constantly saying, for example, إخوان, why can't we all come together? Why can't we all be together? And we say yes, but what is that unity going to be based upon? Is it going to be an empty unity? Everyone is in the same building? Everyone is wearing the same affair? La ya ikhwana barifikum, rather it is a matter of adherence to the Book of Allah and to the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is the affair. It is unity based upon that matter, upon adherence to the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Otherwise, those who unite upon innovation have not united, but rather they have separated. And that is the meaning of iftiraq. That is the meaning of separate. They have separated themselves from the haq. They have separated themselves from the jama'ah. As for those, ikhwan, who unite upon the truth, then they have united, even if they are few in number. Even if they are small in number, ya ikhwan, amongst a large and great population. In the reality, ikhwan, they are the jama'ah. They are the jama'ah. And this is what we find, ikhwan, in this tremendous narration, the wordings of these narrations that we have mentioned. And this is what we find in the meaning of those affairs, as the ulama of Islam have explained for us. So the Shaykh says, every good comes in unity of this ummah upon the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of His Prophet, alayhi salatu wassalam. وَإِن تَعْتَسِمْ بِهَذَا الْكِتَابِ وَبِهَذِهِ السُنَّةِ. And that they come together and hold on together by this book, the Book of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, and by this sunnah, meaning the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad alayhi salatu wassalam. وَالشَّرْ كُلَّ الشَّرْ. And every evil, ya ikhwan, fi dunya wal akhirah, not just in the worldly life, but in the akhirah, in the afterlife, every evil, Allah barifikum, ikhwan, in this life, in the afterlife, bi mukhalafat al kitabi wa sunnah wal iftiraq, it comes in opposition to the Book of Allah and to the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad, and also to ikhwan al iftiraq, dividing from yani the jama'ah. And then the Shaykh says, إخوان, لأن الافتراق لا ينشأ إلا عن مخالفة هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. Because division, إخوان, only comes about due to opposition to the guidance of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Where does division actually come from? Not the division that the people يعني pretend is division. When they begin to say, إخوان, that the people of Sunnah are always causing division, they say that the people of Sunnah are always causing division. Those Salafis are always dividing the people. La ya ikhwan. Al-iftiraq. Division. Comes, ikhwan, in those who have opposed the guidance of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What is the iftiraq of the Ummah, ikhwan? It is, as we mentioned, those groups. The Qadariya, the Murjiya, the Rawafid, the Khawarij. These groups, ikhwan, they are those who have divided from the jama'ah. They are those who have separated themselves. So separation, ikhwan, comes in opposition to the guidance of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. That is the true separation, ikhwan. Separation from the truth. Separation from the haq. And therefore, ikhwan, do not be fooled. Do not be deceived. Do not be deluded, ikhwan, by those individuals who claim that those who have called to the sunnah and called to salafiyah and have remained firm in that way, ikhwan, and firm upon that path. Do not be fooled and deluded into believing, ikhwan, that they are those who have caused division. But in reality, ikhwan, they have called to unity. They have called to unity. Because the only unity we have, ikhwan, is based upon the book of Allah and the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah, Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. Anything that causes anything besides it, ikhwan, causes a division. Causes the separation, causes the separation, causes the division, causes the dividing. The Shaykh says after this, ikhwan, لأن الافتراق, and we mentioned this, يعني, إلا من بقي متمسكا بهديه. يعني, so in other words, ikhwan, those people have divided except those who what? Those who remain clinging firmly to his guidance. وَعَاظًا بِنَوَاجِدِهِ عَلَى مَا كَانَ عَلَيْهِ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. And those who bite down with their molar teeth. This comes from the narration, of course. Those who bite down with their molar teeth upon that affair, ikhwan. Upon the, what the Prophet ﷺ was upon, wa khulafahu ar-rashidun, and his rightly guided successors, wa sahabatu al-akramun, and those noble companions of his, wa radwanullah alayhim ajma'een. I mean, Allah be pleased with all of them. Ameen. So the Shaykh, he continues, fa sa'ada kulla sa'ada. The true happiness, all happiness. So true happiness, ikhwan, wal khair, kull al khair, and every good, ikhwan, fi suluk as-sirat al-mustaqim, it comes, ikhwan, in following the straight path. It comes in adherence and following the straight way. Utiba' al-nabi, al-ameen. And following, ikhwan, the path of that truthful, trustworthy prophet, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the following of his companions, his noble companions. فَإِنَّهُمْ مَا حَادُوا عَنْ تَرِيقِهِ وَلَا خَالَفُوا هَدْيَهُ صَلَّى اللَّهِ وَسَلَّمْ لَا فِي عَقِيدَتِهِ وَلَا فِي عِبَادَاتِهِمْ أَجْمَعِينَ. And then the Shaykh, he mentions, ikhwan, as for those, Allah ibadah fiikum, from the companions, and they are those, ikhwan, who have traversed upon that way, and they did not, yani, differ, they did not oppose his guidance, not in their aqeedah, not in their creed, nor in their acts of worship. May Allah be pleased with them all. وَلَقَدْ كَانُوا مُجْتَمِعِينَ عَلَىٰ عَقِيدَةٍ وَاحِدَةٍ. And this is a very important point, ikhwan. Those companions, ikhwan, were united upon one creed. Their aqeedah was one. So do not let those individuals, ikhwan, come to you and tell you that the companions of the Prophet ﷺ differed in aqeedah. Do not let those individuals, ikhwan, come to you and tell you that the companions differed in the aqidah. Rather, as our Shaykh has mentioned, as the ulama have mentioned, ikhwan, from the scholars of the past, Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah and other than him, ya ikhwan, from the ulama have mentioned that the creed of the companions was one. So those individuals who now try to come, ikhwan, who have tried to come and say that the companions differed in creed, understand what their reasoning is. Understand what their point is, ikhwan. You have to always question and ask yourself, what is the intention? What is the aim? What is the goal behind this point? Well, the aim is clear. If the companions, as they say, if the companions, ikhwan, differed in creed, and they still had the bonds of brotherhood with them, then why can't we all come together, and why can't we all be united, even if we differ in creed and methodology? That is the point, ikhwan, that they want to try to establish from their statement that the companions differed in creed. As our Shaykh has mentioned, ikhwan, لا يخوان لبرفيكم, rather they were united upon one creed. وعلى منهج واحد, and upon one methodology. وليس في أحد منهم أي بدع, and there was not amongst any one of them, ikhwan, any innovation. So do not again be fooled, ikhwan, by those who claim Salafiyah. They claim sunnah, but yet, ikhwan, they accuse the companions of innovation. They accuse the companions of falling into innovation and beginning with some of these innovations. La, ya ikhwan, you do not find innovation from those companions of the Messenger of Allah, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah is pleased with them, and they are pleased with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These are the noble companions of the Messenger of Allah, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ikhwan, and we don't speak in this fashion. And we don't allow those who talk like this, ikhwan, we don't give them any ear. We reject their statement, ikhwan. The first of it and the last of it. This is the reality, ikhwan, of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. They do not, ikhwan, allow anyone, ikhwan, to defame and disparage and denigrate the noble companions of the Messenger of Allah, Muhammad alayhi salatu wassalam. And then the Shaykh says, وَإِنْ حَصَلَ بَيْنَهُمْ اِخْتِلَافِ اِجْتِهَادِ. And even if, ikhwan, there came from them, yani, different as it relates to the issues of ijtihad, تَبْقَى بَيْنَهُمْ آسِلَةِ الْإِخْوَةِ. There remained amongst them, ikhwan, the bonds of brotherhood. Again, this is different, ikhwan. I'm talking about the affairs of creed. We're talking about, ikhwan, some of those matters. those subsidiary matters and the likes of this that they may have different in. لَكِنُّهُمْ لَا يَارُجِ اِخْتِلَافُهُمْ إِلَى اِخْتِلَافِ الْمَنْهَجِ. But they're differing, look what the Shaykh says, does not relate or connect to a differing in manhaj. It does not relate to a differing in manhaj. وَلَا يَارُجِ عَلَى اِخْتِلَافِ الْعَقِيدَةِ. Nor does Ikhwan return or refer to a differing in the affairs of creed. This is important, Ikhwan, لَا يَبْرِ فِيكُمْ. And that is why Ikhwan, those scholars from the Salaf al-Salih, they said regarding the companions, نَسْكُرْ عَمَّا جَرَى بَيْنَهُمْ. We remain quiet about that which transpired between the companions. We don't find the people of Sunnah Ikhwan pointing out and focusing on that which transpired between the companions. Rather, Ikhwan, the people of Sunnah, praise the companions and honor the companions and raise the companions. And as for some that we find today, Ikhwan, you find them, Ikhwan, claiming Salafiyah, claiming Sunnah. However, you find them, Ikhwan, disparaging the companions of the Messenger of Allah, Muhammad SAW. And claiming that they differed in creed. And all of these matters, Ikhwan, that we find from these individuals, Ikhwan, as we said, with their different goals and aims. And then the Shaykh says, وَرَأَوْ أَنَّ مِنَ الشَّرِّ أَن نَذْكُرَ شَيْئًا مِمَّا اخْتَلَفُوا فِيهِ. And those scholars from the Salaf, Ikhwan, from the past, they saw it as evil, as wrong, Ikhwan, to mention those things that they differed in regarding, as we said, some of those matters. نَذْكُرَ شَيْئًا مِنْ مَثَالِبِهِمْ, or mention some of their shortcomings. وَقَالُوا فِي مَنْ تَنَقَصُهُمْ إِنَّهُ زِنْدِيقُ وَإِنَّهُ الرَّافِدِ خَبِيثُ. And then the Shaykh says, as we said, or to mention those things, those shortcomings. And those scholars from the past, Ikhwan, they said about those who defamed the companions, those who despised the companions and denigrated them. They said about them, Ikhwan, zindiq, heretic. They said about them, Ikhwan, rafidi khabith, a evil, despicable rafidi. This is what they said about those individuals, Ikhwan, who would have the audacity to disparage the companions of the Messenger of Allah, Muhammad SAW. And nowadays, Ikhwan, you find the people who claim the Sunnah, who claim Salafiyah, who come in the garment of the Sunnah. And you find them, Ikhwan, attacking the companions of the Messenger of Allah, Muhammad SAW, Ikhwan. And as some of the ulama have mentioned, Ikhwan, when you want to look at the people of innovation, one of the first places they begin, Ikhwan, with their defamation. They begin with the companions of the Messenger of Allah, Muhammad SAW. Why, Ikhwan? Because as the ulama of the past have mentioned, they feel, Ikhwan, if they are able to remove the carriers of the message, then they can remove the message itself. If they can remove, Ikhwan, the position and the station of the carriers of the message, then by default, Ikhwan, they can remove the very message itself. For who did this religion come down to? How was it passed down to us, Ikhwan? Except by way of the noble companions, the hadith of the Messenger of Allah, Muhammad SAW. عن أبي هريرة عن أبي بكر عن عثمان عن عمر. Look at the narrations, Ikhwan. They come by way of those noble companions. So when these individuals, Ikhwan, disparage the companions, Ikhwan, they are trying, Ikhwan, to attack the very message, the very sunnah of the Messenger of Allah, Muhammad SAW, Ikhwan, that he came with. So this is important for us, Ikhwan, to be mindful of this and to remember this. بإذن الله تبارك وتعالى. So the Shaykh, he says, هذا الباب استهله بحديث الافتراق. So this chapter, Ikhwan, he began, يعني with that, this narration of the division or the dividing of the ummah. And he mentioned the Prophet ﷺ أخبر بالجملة أن الأمة ستفترق إلى 73 فرقة كلها في النار إلا واحدة. And then he mentions, Ikhwan, a number, as we said, a number of narrations in their different wordings as it relates to this regarding the ummah dividing into 73 different sects, all of them in the hellfire except for one. And then he mentions, Ikhwan, a number of those who reported these narrations, Abu Huraira, as we mentioned, Ikhwan, Muawiyah, and other than Anas ibn Malik, and other than them, Ikhwan, from those noble companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. وَأَخْبَرَ عَنْ أَمْرٍ مُسْتَقْبَلٍ. And he mentioned the Prophet as informed of a matter from in the future. And this goes back to what I mentioned previously, Ikhwan, in the beginning of the lesson, regarding yani why Sheikh Muqbil has mentioned that the likes of this narration is from the proofs of prophethood. Well, this narration from the proofs of prophethood, as our Prophet ﷺ was informing Ikhwan of something that would take place in the future. And it is, we have said, Ikhwan, that the ummah would divide into 73 different sects. And then he says after this, Ikhwan, هذه نبوة, يعني this يعني narration that we have mentioned, يعني تحققت, يعني it has come to pass. We have seen the division, as we said, of the ummah, dividing into the different sects and schisms. And listen to this, ikhwan. This is very important for us to understand. وَنَحْنُ لَا مَا نَفْرَحْ بِهَذَا. يعني we're not happy with this. Some people, ikhwan, they act as if, when we mention the likes of this narration, if we have heard some actually reject this narration. Some of the people of innovation, ikhwan, they reject the likes of this narration. Or, ikhwan, they try to bring their yani interpretations and their statements regarding it. And from the things that they say, ikhwan, they say as the individuals when they recite this narration is as if they are pleased with this or they're happy with this. This is not the point. This is not yani the aim. Rather, as we see here, ikhwan, the Prophet was merely informing us of the reality. Rather, ikhwan, it is something to warn us. So that we can be ala hadarin, ikhwan, we can be on our P's and Q's, as it is said. We can be cautious, ikhwan, and wary as it relates to these affairs. So we're not pleased, ikhwan, with separation. We're not pleased with division. That pains Ahl Sunnah, ya ikhwan, to see the people, ikhwan, leave off from the Sunnah and reject the Sunnah and contradict the Sunnah. It pains the people of Sunnah, ya ikhwan. Allah barifikum. Innama nakhaf wa nahdhar wa na'rif al-haqiqa wal-waqi' wal-makhraj min hadhihi al-mataahat. Listen to this, ikhwan. Rather, ikhwan, we're not pleased with this. It's not a matter that pleases us or makes us happy. Rather, we're only fearful and cautious and aware of the reality of the matter, ikhwan, as it is. One has to be aware of the affair as it is. One cannot go, ikhwan, about with blinders on, as we said, talking about empty unity, but rather understanding and knowing, ikhwan, about the ikhtilaf, as we said, and the reality of that affair, and the escape, ikhwan, or the way out from these mazes. فَكُلُّ فِرْقَةٍ تَدَّعِي أَنَّهَا عَلَى الْحَقِّ. And this is another important point, ikhwan. Every group, ikhwan, alleges and claims that it is upon the truth. And Shaykh al-Albani, ikhwan, rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentioned this in numerous recordings. You listen to a number of those recordings from Shaykh al-Albani, rahimahullah ta'ala, ikhwan, and the Shaykh is giving, yani, mentioning the explanation of the likes of the narration of the dividing of the ummah that we read and talked about. And sometimes, ikhwan, you hear numerous different recordings in different settings. And Shaykh al-Albani is almost giving the same talk, ikhwan, in a number of different settings. Why? Because of the importance of this issue. So you find the Shaykh, for example, in one setting, and he's talking about this affair. And almost word for word in another setting, you hear the Shaykh giving the same exhortation, the same speech, the same talk. And then you listen to another recording, ikhwan, it's almost the same exact speech. The repetition, ikhwan, is because of the importance of this matter. Because of the importance of this affair. Allah yabarifikum. Shaykh al-Albani, he mentioned, ikhwan, that any person that you go to, any group that you go to from amongst the Muslims, ikhwan, whether it be Rafili, whether it be Sufi, whatever it may be, who from amongst them is going to say, I am not upon the Quran and the way of the Prophet? Who's going to negate that and reject that from those people? I'm not upon what the Quran says. I'm not upon the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. يعني صريحا هكذا. Explicitly in that manner. Sheikh Nasser says, what you're going to find amongst these groups, ikhwan, this is important for us to understand. What you're going to find amongst these groups, ikhwan, is all of them are going to lay claim to being the group. All of them are going to lay claim to being that saved sect. All of them are going to lay claim, ikhwan, to being in truth upon the book of Allah and the sunnah of the Prophet. And the Shaykhuna Shaykh Rabi, he echoes that same speech, that same kalam of Shaykh al-Albani. He says that they're going to say, ikhwan, وَأَنَّ الْإِسْلَامِ عِنْدَهَا, that the Islam is with them, with their group. وَأَنَّهُمْ هُمَ تَبَعَ الرَّسُولِ, and that they are the followers of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. لَكِنَ الْفَيْصَلُ هُوَ مَا قَالَ الرَّسُولُ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. مَنْ كَانَ عَلَى مَا أَنَا عَلَيْهِ وَصْحَابِي. But what is the criterion, ikhwan? The criterion is that statement of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what I am upon today and my companions. Go back and look at the book Faidh al-Qadir, ikhwan, by al-Manawi. And in the explanation of this narration, even back then, ikhwan al-Manawi, he mentioned something very similar to this. He says, ikhwan, that every group is going to lay claim to being the jama'ah. He says, so how does one distinguish and differentiate between the different sects, between the different schisms, to realize who is upon the truth and who is upon falsehood? He said, weigh every group's statement and every group's action in accordance with those statements of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is all you need, Ikhwans, to weigh their statements. So when the Prophet ﷺ said, "La tusubu ashabi," do not insult and curse my companions. There is the narration. There is one side of the scale. Now you put the statement of the Rafida on the other side of the scale. Those who curse the companions and insult the companions and abuse the companions. You put their statements on the other side of that scale. And you find that they are found wanting. That they are found lacking. So whether they claim to be upon that way or not, Ikhwan, they're not upon that way. The Prophet ﷺ prohibited taking the places of worship as graves, as places of the graves as places of worship. So you put that in one scale, Ikhwan, and then you put the actions of the Quburiyin, the people of the Qubur, of the graves, in the other side of that scale. And you find them lacking. You find them wanting, ya Ikhwan. So therefore, whether they say that they are the saved group, whether they say they are upon that which is correct, you weigh their statements and their actions in accordance with that which the Prophet ﷺ came with. And the reality becomes apparent for all who have eyes to see. This is the reality of the affair, ya Ikhwan. It is not a matter of a mere claim. It's not a matter, Ikhwan, of a mere statement. But rather it is an adherence to that statement or those statements of the Prophet ﷺ and that which those companions were upon. This is what we mentioned from Sheikh Al-Albani, from Al-Manawi, from Sheikh Rabir. Just look, Ikhwan, look in the different works of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, and you will find the self-same statement. You will find the self-same statement, Ikhwan. For the methodology of Ahl Sunnah is one. And then the Sheikh, he says after this, Ikhwan, wal Jama'ah, wal Jama'ah, ya'ani allati ijtama'at al-haq wal Jama'ah, ya'ani those who have ya'ani adhered to the truth in the Jama'ah, الذي جاء به محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم, that was what the Prophet ﷺ came with, وكان عليه هو وأصحابه, and that which he and his companions were upon, عقيدة, in their creed, وشريعة, in legislation, وسياسة, in politics. And when we say politics, Ikhwan, we mean the politics that come from the Sharia. الشيخ الشيخ مقبل إخوان رحمه الله تعالى, he mentions in his tremendous work, this tremendous treatise, Ikhwan, هذه دعوتنا وعقيدتنا, this is our call and our creed. The Sheikh, he mentions, Ikhwan, first and foremost, that we are not يعني, upon the politics of the of these different schisms and sects, the likes of the Ikhwan Muslimun, who have fallen into these politics and that take them away from the book and the sunnah. But then later on in that same treatise, the Sheikh, he mentions, Ikhwan, that we adhere to the politics found in the book of Allah and the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad that come from those two sources. So the Sheikh, he said after this, Ikhwan, وَفِي كُلِّ شَأْنٍ مِنْ شُؤُونِ الْحَيَاةِ, in every aspect, in every area of one's life, قَالَ اللَّهُ قَالَ رَسُولَ اللَّهُ, what Allah said and what His Messenger said. That is, Ikhwan, what is to be put forward in every aspect, in every area of our lives, Ikhwan, the statements of Allah and His Messenger, صلى الله عليه وسلم. هذا المنهج لا تجده إلا عند أهل الحديث. This is nice, Ikhwan. This methodology that we just mentioned, Ikhwan, you only find it with the people of Hadith. This methodology that we just mentioned, Ikhwan, is as simple as it is. That adherence to the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, you only find that, Ikhwan, with أهل السنة والجماعة أهل الحديث. هو العظ بالنواجذ على ما جاء به محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. Ikhwan, he says, it is that biting down, holding down, with one's molar teeth, yani upon molar teeth upon the way of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, wa ala fahm as-salaf, and in accordance with the understanding of the salaf, wa ala manhajihim, and upon their methodology, wa ala tariqihim, and upon their path, wa istidlali istidlal, and their means and ways, Ikhwan, of extracting and bringing forth proofs and evidences. And we mentioned something of this, Ikhwan, and that which we read from Sheikh al-Sheikh Rabi and other settings. Walillah alhamd. And then the Sheikh, he said after this, Ikhwan, Allah yabarifikum, wa'ala minhajihim fil aqidah wal ibadah, and upon their methodology and creed and in worship. And then he said after this, Ikhwan, la najidu hadha illa inda firqa wahida. We only find this, Ikhwan, what we have mentioned, with one group. We only find this with one group. التي شهد لها خيار الأمة من فجر تاريخها إلى يومنا هذا أنهم أهل الحديث. And this has been testified, Ikhwan, by the best of this Ummah from the beginning of its history until this day of ours, Ikhwan, that testimony is for the people of Hadith. It is for the people of Hadith. And when you look back, Ikhwan, in the history of this blessed faith, you find, Ikhwan, that those who defended the Sunnah and those who refuted the people of innovation in every era, in every generation, came from the people of Hadith. Look back, ya Ikhwan. Look back at Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal and what he went through, Ikhwan, from his mihna, from his trial, Ikhwan, in defense of the methodology of Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah, until he is called what? Imam Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah. The Imam of Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah, because of the stance that he took, Ikhwan, and refutation of the Jahmiyyah, and the harm that he suffered, the torture that he suffered, the imprisonment that he suffered, because of his defense of the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad wasallam in refutation of the groups of innovation. Go to the history, Ikhwan, of Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, being in prison how many times, Ikhwan, until dying in the prison, due to his defense of the Aqidah and the Minhaj of Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah. This is the reality, Ikhwan, of the noble Imam defending the Sunnah. Look at Imam al-Bukhari in his time, look at Muslim in his time, look at Abu Dawood, look at the scholars, Ikhwan, of Hadith. And so our time, Ikhwan, Shaykh Wana Shaykh Muqbil, Shaykh Rabi'ir, Shaykh Abdul Muhsin, Shaykh Al-Fawzan, these scholars, Ikhwan, of Hadith, these scholars of Sunnah, Ikhwan, la ibari fikum, Shaykh Wana Shaykh Ubaid al-Jabri, defenders of the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, refuting those groups of innovation and those peoples of innovation, ya Ikhwan. So he says after this, Ikhwan, la ibari fikum, لِأَنَّ أَخِيرَتَهُمْ تَقُومْ عَلَى الْكِتَابِ وَالسُنَّةِ وَلَا حَدِيثِ. Because their creed, Ikhwan, is based upon the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, the narrations, the authentic narrations of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad alayhi salatu wassalam. How much time we got? 15? So with that, Ikhwan, I wanted, inshallah ta'ala, to read as it relates to the first group to divide and separate from the Ummah. The first group to divide and separate from the Ummah. And there are, of course, Ikhwan, the Khawarij. There are, of course, the Khawarij. And then the Khawarij will soon madhahibi him. And the evil of the Khawarij and their methodologies, wa ibaha qitalihim, and the permission to fight them, wa thawab man qatalahum aw qatalu, and the reward for those who kill them or those who are killed by them. Al-Ajurri, Ikhwan, he mentions rahimahullah regarding these Khawarij. Lam yakhtalif al-ulama qadiman wa hadithan anna al-Khawarij qawm su, that the ulama of al-Islam, Ikhwan, whether past or present, they have not differed, Ikhwan, that the Khawarij are an evil people. They are an evil group. Usatun lillah. Disobedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa li rasulihi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and to his messenger. Wa in sallu wa samu. Even if they pray and fast. Wa ijtahadu fil ibadah. And even if they are diligent in actions of worship. And this is important, ya ikhwan. Even if they are diligent in actions of worship, فَلَيْسَ ذَلِكَ بِنَافِعٍ لَهُمْ, for this is not beneficial to them. Allahu Akbar. This is not beneficial for them. Even if they pray, and even if they fast, and even if they are diligent in ibadah, it doesn't benefit them. It's not beneficial for them. لِأَنَّهُمْ قَوْمٌ فَلَيْسَ ذَلِكَ بِنَافِعٍ لَهُمْ. When أَظْهَرُ الْأَمَرَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَالنَّهْيَ عَنَ الْمُنْكَرِ. Afwan, he says, Ikhwan, even if they give the appearance of enjoining the good and forbidding the evil. Even if they give the outward appearance, Ikhwan, of enjoining the good and forbidding the evil. So they give the outward appearance, as we talked about earlier, Ikhwan, those who come in the dress, in the garment of truth, who come in the garment of good. These individuals, Ikhwan, from the people of the Khawarij, these people of innovation, they come in the garment of enjoining the good and forbidding the evil. This is their claim. We are only enjoining the good and we are only forbidding the evil. Is it not, Ikhwan, what those individuals in those circles were saying? When Abdullah ibn Mas'ud came to them and he asked them, what are you doing in these circles? Dhikring in a fashion, yani supplicating in a fashion that was not in accordance with the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And they said, what? We're only supplicating. We are only supplicating. So these individuals, Ikhwan, want to give the appearance of good and of ibadah, So the Sheikh, he says, Ikhwan, yani al-ajur, he says, Ikhwan, that they want to give the appearance of enjoining the good and forbidding the evil. وَلَيْسَ ذَلِكَ بِنَافِعٍ لَهُمْ But it is not a benefit for them. It is not a benefit for them. And then he goes on to mention, لِأَنَّهُمْ قَوْمْ يَتَأَوَّلُونَ الْقُرْآنَ عَلَى مَا يَهْوُونَ Because, Ikhwan, they interpret the Quran in accordance with their desires. And we mentioned this before, Ikhwan. Sheikh Ahmed al-Najmi, Rahimahullah ta'ala, Ikhwan, his explanation of Kitab al-Sunnah from the Sunnah of Abi Dawood, he says for us, Ikhwan, he explains for us that from the problems of the Khawarij, Ikhwan, is that they reject the Sunnah. They reject the Sunnah. This is from, Ikhwan, the creed and the way, Ikhwan, of those Khawarij, the methodology of those Khawarij, that they reject the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad, and they interpret the Quran in accordance with their desires. So they may be reciters of the Quran, but they don't understand its meaning. And they oppose it in their actions. And as we see clearly here, Ya Ikhwan la Bilifikum, they interpret it based upon their desires. This is what we find in the narration of Ibn Abbas. When Ibn Abbas went to the Khawarij, Ikhwan, to debate them, you found them, Ikhwan, mentioning verses in the Quran and not understanding the meaning of those verses. Ibn Abbas refuted them, Ikhwan. And that affair. يموهون على المسلمين. They disguise themselves, Ikhwan, before the Muslims. وقد حذرنا الله عز وجل منهم. Allah has warned us from them. وحذرنا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم has warned us from them. وحذرناهم الخلفاء الراشدون بعده. And the rightly guided successors after him warned us from them, Ya Ikhwan. وحذرناهم الصحابة. And the companions warned us from them, Ya Ikhwan. وَمَنْ تَبِعُمْ بِإِحْسَانٍ And those who follow them in righteousness. Every generation, Ikhwan, has warned from the people of Ahl al-Sunnah, have warned from the Khawarij. Have warned from this evil sect and group, Ikhwan, that is divided from the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he says after this, Ikhwan, Allah yabarifikum, and he, regarding those who follow them in righteousness, rahmatullah alayhim, may Allah have mercy upon them. والخوارج هم الشرات والأنجاس والأرجاس يعني these خوارج إخوانا evil, filthy, despicable individuals ومن كان على مذهبهم من سائر الخوارج يتوارثون هذا المذهب قديما وحديثا and those إخوان who are upon their methodology from the other affairs of the خوارج they have inherited their madhab whether it is of today or of the past يعني old and new and old And as we know, Ikhwan, there are different yani schisms even amongst those Khawarij. Who knows, Ikhwan, the most despicable of the Khawarij? Those have been called the most despicable of the Khawarij. Huh? Cave?
It sounds like you're saying it, but I can't hear you.
Yani. No, Al-Qa'adiyya. Yeah, that's what you were saying, Al-Qa'adiyya. No. Al-Qa'adiyya min al-Khawarij. Naam. The ulama have mentioned, Ikhwan, they're the akhbath, the most despicable of the Khawarij. And that is because, Ikhwan, these individuals, even though, Ikhwan, they don't actually raise the sword themselves, neither they don't actually pull the trigger themselves, but they are those who incite the people towards it. They are those who call the people towards it. They are those who invite the people towards it and make it fair-seeming amongst the people. Sheikh Uthaymeen, Ikhwan, has a tremendous similitude that he gives to explain this. Sheikh Uthaymeen, rahimahullah ta'ala, Ikhwan, he described it like this. In the narration of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that all of the children of Adam have their portion of zina. Al-aynu tazni. The eye fornicates with zinaha, another. And the fornication of the eye is the seeing, the looking. Wal-udhan tazni. Wa zinaha al-istima'a. The ear fornication, the fornication of the ear is the listening. The tongue fornication, the fornication of the tongue is the talking, the hands fornicating, the fornication of the hands is the touching, the feet fornicating, the fornication of the feet is the walking. And the private parts either affirm that or negate that. Now look what Sheikh Uthaymeen says. Sheikh Uthaymeen says, Ikhwan, oh, by the way, Ikhwan, who's the narrator of that hadith and who collects it? Who's the narrator of that narration and who collects it from the scholars of hadith? محمود من عندك؟
أبو عمر.
وين عمر؟ عمر لا هي. ها. لا 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 نعطي شيك. هذا عمر. هذا عمر. لا لا لا. زاهر ما عندك؟ عندك؟ أبو هريرة متفق عليه. The narration of Abu Huraira agreed upon by Bukhari and Muslim. So check out the Imam Ikhwan, what he says regarding this tremendous narration, Ikhwan, is that it doesn't start at the greater fornication, the greater zina. It starts with those things that lead towards the greater zina. What the eye sees that is pleasing. What the ear hears that is pleasing. What the tongue says that is pleasing. What the hands touch that is to the end of that, right? And then the greater act of the private parts comes at the end of that affair, either yani that which is either negated or affirmed by those private parts. So Shaykh Uthaymeen says, likewise, with the affair of khuruj, likewise with the affair of rebellion and revolution, Shaykh Uthaymeen says, no one says, all right, come on, grab your weapons, let's go. It doesn't work like that. The groundwork must be laid. Someone must lay the groundwork first, Ikhwan. Call to it, invite to it, make it fair seeming, bring shubahat surrounding it. And therefore, Ikhwan, they're able under those circumstances, Ikhwan, to have the people to go out and to make this khuruj. So he said after this, Ikhwan, that they are a people who have inherited this. وَيَخْرُجُونَ عَلَى الْأَئِمَّةِ وَالْأُمَرَاءِ. Those who have rebelled against the a'immah, the imams, the rulers. يستحلون قتل المسلمين, and they make permissible, Ikhwan, the killing of the Muslims. And they first appeared, Ikhwan, you know, the first appearance of that which we see of them, or their methodology, was during the time of the Prophet ﷺ, هو الرجل انتعنا على رسول الله ﷺ, a person who defamed, spoke disrespectfully. So the Messenger of Allah Muhammad ﷺ, as he was dividing up the spoils, قال اعدل اعدل أعدل يا محمد. Be just, O Muhammad. فما أراك تعدل. For I do not see you being just. And then he said, Rasulullah sallam said, ويلك, woe to you. فمن يعدل إذا لم أكن أعدل. Who will be just if I am not just? Who will be just if I am not just? فأراد عمر قتله. And Umar wanted to take him out. Umar wanted to deal with him. فَمَنَعَهُ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ مِنْ قَتْلِهِ. But Rasulullah prevented him from killing him. But he said regarding him, Ikhwan, that they will come from the loins of this man, يعني أصحابٍ لَهُ يَحْيِرْ أَحَدُكُمْ صَلَاتُهُ مَعَ صَلَاتِهِمْ. That one of you will be jealous of your prayer next to their prayer. وَصِيَامَهُ مَعَ صِيَامِهِمْ. And your fast or their fasting beside their fasting. يَمْرُقُونَ مِنَ الدِّينِ كَمَا يَمْرُقُ السَّهْمُ مِنَ الرَّمِيَةِ. And they will exit the religion faster than the animal, or than the arrow goes to the hunted animal. وَأَمَرَ عَلَيْهِ سَلَّمَ وَسَلَّمَ فِي غَيْرِ حَدِيثٍ. And he commands in another narration, another wording, بِقِتَالِهِمْ, with fighting them. وَبَيَّنَ فَضْلَ مَنْ قَتَلَهُمْ أَوْ قَتَلُوا. And clarified, Ikhwan, the virtue in those who kill them or are killed by them. ثم إنهم بعد ذلك خرجوا من بلدان شتى. And after this, Ikhwan, they appeared. They came out. They were present in a number of different countries. واجتمعوا وأظهروا الأمر بالمعروف والنهي عن المنكر. And again, Ikhwan, they came together and they gave the appearance of enjoining the good and forbidding the evil. حتى قدموا المدينة فقتلوا عثمان بن عفان. And so they came and did what, Ikhwan? They came and they killed عثمان بن عفان رضي الله عنه. And it shows us, Ikhwan, that the opinion, the position of Al-Ajri is that those who killed Uthman were from the Khawarij. As the ulama, we know there's a difference of opinion regarding this. And he said, after this, Ikhwan, وَقَدْ اجْتَهَدَ أَصْحَابُ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ مِمَّنْ كَانَ فِي الْمَدِينَةِ فِيَلَّا يُقْتَلْ عُثْمَانِ فَمَا أَطَاقُوا ذَلِكَ رَجِلَهُ عَنْهُمْ. And it mentions, Ikhwan, that the companions of the Prophet ﷺ were diligent, those in Medina were diligent, Ikhwan, to prevent Uthman from being killed, but they were unable to stop it. May Allah be pleased with those noble companions. Then he mentions it regarding the Khawarij, Ikhwan. ثُمَّ خَرَجُوا بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ عَلَى أَمِيرُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ عَلِي بِنْ أَبِي طَالِبٍ. And then, Ikhwan, they rebelled and revolted against the leader of the faithful, Ali ibn Abi Talib. وَلَمْ يَرْضَى بِحُكْمِهِ. And they were not pleased with his rule. وَأَظْهَرُوا قَوْلَهُمْ وَقَالُوا لَا حُكْمَ إِلَّا لِلَّهِ. And they made their statement, Ikhwan, there is no rule except for the rule of Allah. فَقَالَ عَلِي كَلِمَ حَقْ أَرَادُوا بِهَا الْبَاطِلِ. Now this is just important, Ikhwan. And then they made their statement, أَلَيْهِ بَلِفِيكُمْ. And he says, I'm going to call you then. After the adhan, inshallah. There's no rule but the rule of Allah. And Ali said, regarding them, إِخْوَانْ كَلِمَ حَقْ أَرَادُوا بِهَا الْبَاطِلِ. They have stated a word of truth, but they intend by it falsehood. And this is a reminder for us, إِخْوَانْ, that not everyone who makes a statement of truth intends by that statement what that truth contains. But we find some people, as we have mentioned before, those who and he claim or call to Salafiyya, but in reality, Ikhwan, their actions oppose and contradict that statement, that claim. So this, Ikhwan, is another reminder for us, Ikhwan, that one must look at a people's actions in accordance with their statements and their intent and their aims behind these statements, so as to see the reality of their affair. For the statement of the Khawarij, as Ali ibn Abi Talib said, was a word of truth. It was a word of truth. But they intended by the Ikhwan to make the blood of the Muslims permissible. And they intended by the Ikhwan to make khuruj, rebellion and revolution against the leaders. So this shows us, Ikhwan, that even though it is a word of truth, what they intended by it is falsehood. فَقَاتَلَهُمْ عَلِي رَجَلَهُ عَنْهُ. So Ali fought them, Ikhwan. فَقْرَمْهُ اللَّهُ بِقَتْلِهِمْ. And Allah blessed him, Ikhwan, to fight them and to kill them. وَأَخْبَرَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ بِفَضْلِ مَنْ قَتَلَهُمْ أَوْ قَتَلُوهُ. And the Prophet ﷺ has mentioned, Ikhwan, the virtue and the one who kills them was killed by them. وَقَاتَلَ مَعَهُ الصَّحَابَةُ. And the companions fought alongside Ali ibn Abi Talib, Ikhwan, against those Khawarij. And it should be mentioned, Ikhwan, and which is interesting, when Ibn Abbas went to those Khawarij, one of the first things he mentioned for them is, Ikhwan, I came from Ali ibn Abi Talib, Yani and the companions. And he said, and there is not a companion amongst you. It was important, Ikhwan, that he pointed out to them, Ikhwan, that there was not a companion amongst those Khawarij. And this was something, Ikhwan, that Ibn Abbas, he mentioned, Ikhwan, when he went to those individuals. فَصَارَ السَّيْفَ عَلِي بِنْ أَبِي طَالِبِ فِي الْخَوَارِجِ السَّيْفِ حَقِّ إِلَىٰ أَنْ تَقُومَ السَّاعَةِ. And the sword of Ali ibn Abi Talib against the Khawarij became the sword of truth until the hour is established. And we'll quickly, Ikhwan, just read yani, something of what Shaykh Rabi'a mentioned yani, in the explanation of this chapter, and then we'll end, inshallah ta'ala. He says, بَلَى الْمُؤَلِّفْ كِتَابُهُ هَذَا بِدَعْوَةِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ الْاِعْتِصَامِ بِكِتَابِ رَبِّهِمْ وَسُنَّةِ نَبِيِّهِمْ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ. So he says, the author began his book by inviting and calling the Muslims to adherence, yani coming together and adhering to the book of Allah and the sunnah of his prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's how he began the book. وَسَاقَ فِي ذَلِكَ آيَاتُ وَحَدِيثٍ. And he cited, Ikhwan, a number of verses and narrations in that regard. وَثَنَّ بِوُجُوبِ لُزُومِ السُنَّةِ. And then the second chapter after this, Ikhwan, he came with what? The obligation of adherence to the sunnah. The obligation of adherence to the sunnah. وَثَلَّثَ بِتَحْرِيمَ الْفُرْقَى وَالْإِخْتِلَافِ. And in the third chapter, what did he come with, Ikhwan? The impermissibility of dividing and differing. Allahu Akbar. Look, Ikhwan, at the fiqh of the ulama. We've mentioned, I don't know how many times previously, Ikhwan, that the scholars of Islam, the scholars of Hadith, the scholars, Ikhwan, of this religion, you can find their understanding and their fiqh in the chaptering, in the way they chapter their books. There is so much to learn and so much to be gained. If you look at Ibn Hajar's explanation of Bukhari, for example, you find Ibn Hajar, Ikhwan, talking at length in Fathul Bari about the tabweeb, the chaptering of Al-Bukhari. Because there's great benefit to be gained from that. And that is what we are seeing now from Shaykhuna Shaykh Rabi'ir in mentioning, Ikhwan, the ordering of these chapters in the book. Again, he begins with what, Ikhwan? Calling the Muslims to, yani, clinging to the book of Allah and the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. Then in the second, the obligation, after calling to it, mentioned that it is obligatory for you to come to this affair. And then thirdly, Ikhwan, the impermissibility of dividing and differing. This is a tremendous, Ikhwan, ordering. of these chapters, and it's tremendous fiqh. And it shows us, Ikhwan, the affairs of giving da'wah and speaking to the people and calling them, Ikhwan. It goes back to what, Ikhwan? It goes back to the warning and the giving of glad tidings. The warning and the giving of glad tidings. This is the reward of those who adhere to the sunnah. This is the reward of those who adhere to the haqq and stick to the jama'ah. This is their reward. And it's tabshir. You give them glad tidings, good exhortations regarding that. Yani good glad tidings regarding that, good news regarding that. And at the same time, Ikhwan, tahdhir. Yani, you warn them also at the same time from what? From dividing and separating and differing. So this shows us, Ikhwan, that affair of da'wah, that affair of calling. This is how Al-Ajur, Ikhwan, chapter this tremendous work. And look what Shaykh Rabi says after this, Ikhwan. وَالْآنْ بَدْأَ يَذْكُرْ أَوَّلْ طَائِفَ فَارَقَةِ الْمَنْهَجِ الْإِسْلَامِ. Then he mentions, after the prohibition of dividing and differing, he mentions the first group to differ. The first group to divide. Look at the chaptering, Ikhwan, of Al-Ajurri. You learn from this. We benefit, Ikhwan, even from the chaptering of this tremendous work. وَخَرَجَتْ عَلَى أُمَّةِ الْإِسْلَامِ. Those who rebelled against the Ummah of Al-Islam. وَعَلَى وَلَاسْ أُمُورِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. And against the rulers of the Muslims. Yani Uthman, thumma Ali, thumma man ba'dahum. First Uthman, and then Ali, and then those who came after them. And we'll end, Ikhwan, la yabarifikum, with the statement of Shaykhna Shaykh Rabi' wa awwal ma kharaju fi ahdi Uthman fi Misr wa fi ghayriha. And the first of those who rebelled during the time of Uthman in Misr and other than it, bada'u yuhayyijuna an-nas 'ala al-khalifati bil manasib wa bil amwal. So they began, Ikhwan, as we said, to incite the people against the Khalifa as it relates to yani positions and money and the likes. And the Sheikh, he mentions in here, Ikhwan, that is the way of the Khawarij of old. That everything with them is about finance, about position. And if you look at Dhul Khawaisra, when he came to the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, what was it about? It was about finance. So this methodology of theirs, Ikhwan, as the Sheikh mentioned, is something that has yani began at that very stage and was passed down. And he says, يَتَظَاهَرُونَ بِالْغَيْرَةِ. They give the outward appearance, Ikhwan, of jealousy for Al-Islam. وَالْأَمْرُ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَنَهْيَ الْمُنْكَرِ. And that they enjoin the good and forbid the evil. فَالتَّارِيخُ يُعِيدُ نَفْسَهُ. And history repeats itself, كَمَا يُقَالَ, as it is said, يعني. فَالْأُمُورُ وَالْقَضَايَا الَّتِي يُدَنْدِنُ حَوْلَهَا الْخَوَارِجُ مُنْذُ دَرَّ قَرْنُ فِتْنَتِهِمْ. And so the affair, Ikhwan, of the Khawarij that they have revolved around. Yani, from the very time that their fitna yani came forth, here it's the same. إخوان إلى يوم القيامة, to the day of judgment. Yani here نفسها التظاهر بالأمر بالمعروف والنهي عن المنكر. It is the appearance of enjoining the good and forbidding of the evil. وقضايا المال, and the affairs of money. وقضايا المناصب, and positions. وهذه الأشياء, and these matters. فجزاكم الله خير يا إخوان. This is yani what we wanted to read from this tremendous work, and again we thank our brothers and our sisters for their patience yani here today, inshallah ta'ala. And we hope to continue to benefit at this tremendous yani conference with our brothers who will continue to speak, and of course benefiting from our mashaykh, the likes of Shaykhuna Shaykh Ubaid al-Jabri and Shaykh Abdullah Bukhari. Hafidhum Allah. May Allah preserve them. Jazakum Allahu khair. لا إله إلا الله.